When the Department of the Navy was established in April of 1798, the ports of Georgia, South Carolina, and North Carolina were suffering from attacks by privateers from Britain, France, and Spain. After a meeting with two representatives from South Carolina, Secretary of the Navy Benjamin Stoddard declared that 6 gun galleys would be built, all equipped with 2 lateen sails, 25 oars, and 1 24-pounder gun. 2 galleys were awarded to each state, all paid for by the U.S. government. At the museum, we feature one of the Georgia galleys, the Savannah. Here to discuss the history of this little vessel is the father of the Navy, second president of the United States, His Excellency John Adams. Mr. President, welcome to Ships of the Sea.
An honor.
You are referred to as the father of the Navy. Tell me why building up that branch of the armed forces was so important to you.
I urged for the passage of the Act establishing the Department of the Navy and a permanent Navy, because the naval power is the natural defense of the United States. We could not, would not sit idly by while French privateers attacked our merchant vessel at their liberty simply because we traded with Great Britain. Our neutrality had to be preserved.
So today, the U.S. Navy claims that this galley was the very first USS Savannah, but she wasn't really a commissioned U.S. Navy vessel, was she?
She was not. She was paid for by the Navy, provisioned by the Navy, and supplied by the Navy. But her officers and crew were all locally selected and volunteered men, more of a naval militia, if you would.
So tell us a little bit about how the 6 galleys were built.
The 6 galleys were built to a plan developed by Josiah Humphreys, who also developed the original 6 frigates, including USS Constitution. They were provisioned for, paid for, and overseen by a naval agent here in Savannah. That was Ebenezer Jackson.
So I understand that Savannah had a very brief lifespan.
She did. She was launched on September 29th, 1798. But by 1799, operational control was passed from Secretary Stoddard in the Department of the Navy to James McHenry and Charles F. Pinckney of the Department of War. They had received orders that they be laid up and dismantled. Savannah and her and 3 other ships, St. Mary's and 2 from North Carolina, would be put to hauling live oak from the Sea Islands for the Navy. By 1802, St. Mary's was back in revenue service, and the Savannah would be sold to a private concern, taking her out of government control.
Well, thank you, Mr. President, for joining us today and shedding some light on the importance of this little galley. And please say hello to Abigail for me.
I shall.
Join us next time as we take a look at the museum's flagship, the SS Savannah, the first steamship to cross the Atlantic Ocean.